Introducing first from Ackworth, Georgia, he weighs in at 245 pounds, a true American, Ranger Ross. Ranger Ross from Ackworth, Georgia, a man that won an accommodation from President Ronald Reagan, a proud member of the United States Ranger Organization. As you said, he has, Gordon, he's got great martial arts training, but he's a good person, and I think that counts for a great deal. I look for a scientific match here, the likes of which we haven't seen in quite some time.
Well, I certainly hope so, and may I just say, too, that as I said before, the one thing that may be serving as a detriment to him is the regimentation, the discipline that he learned while he was in the service.
His opponent represents the Four Horsemen. He is the current World's Television Champion, weighing in at 249 pounds from the great state of Minnesota, Double A, Arn Anderson.
I want to tell you, I got to take my hat off to Arn Anderson, because Gordon, when he won the title on the Power Hour here on TBS, he said at that time, I talked with him after the matches, I'm going to defend the title as often as they will sign contracts. I'm going to give guys deserving of the opportunity. I don't care who it is. And this is representative of the competitive attitude of the horseman. Ranger Ross has won his share of matches, but as the fans know, he's also lost his share. He's improved every single week. His one-loss record is certainly representative to earn him a chance at that belt. I'm proud of Arn Anderson for giving Ranger Ross this opportunity.
Well, I certainly am, too, and it carries on the Anderson tradition. The old Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Ole Anderson, of course, Gene Anderson and all, have instilled that in the Anderson family. But this thing with Ross, what I was trying to get to with him is he's going to have to learn to sometimes throw out the rule book. He believes in abiding by the rules. As you mentioned, we're looking for a scientific match. But he's going to have to learn that there are times that has to be thrown out.
Nice arm bar, or hammerlock rather. Nice drop toe there by Arn Anderson. Back on the advantage, Ranger Ross trying to set out. And very quickly he does that. Anderson, if you look at the matchups, the physical matchups, Anderson, obviously, the edge in power, the edge in strength. His mass is going to be a factor in this event. Ranger Ross, cat quick, has great agility, and he also has the combat kick. Arn Anderson has the DDT. We saw the Freebirds use it earlier. There's a pinning predicament right there, and he got him over. I feel like this one's going to end up between, Gordon, that combat kick, Anderson evading it, staying away from it, and Ranger Ross has got to stay away from the DDT.
He does indeed, and it could be just a situation where which man makes the first mistake.
Nice counter move there by Ranger Ross, side headlock. Anderson working his way back up to a base, he does so. Good football tackle by the Ranger, and very quickly goes for the pin.
Perhaps just a bit early because both men are still very fresh. Referee Nick Patrick stepping in between them. Here's a young fellow who has started off as a career in professional wrestling, totally blew out his knee and has stayed with the sport. Ah, good sportsmanship here.
Arn Anderson, great gesture of sportsmanship, but never forget, this is a business. The winners win the money. They win the most money. They make the most money. Championships bring you more money. So, as you said, Ranger Ross may have to put some of his ethics aside and really go all out for this championship any way he can, because, quite frankly, Arn Anderson will do what he has to do to keep it. There's another pinning predicament. He's got him down. There's that quickness we talked about. And Anderson's a little frustrated and surprised, perhaps.
Well, it was a good duck under, go behind, and hooked this man very nicely, brought him down. And I don't believe Anderson thought that Ross was nearly that fast.
I agree with you. Ranger Ross knows that if the pace slows, that man will have the advantage, because the Anderson's methodical style is, I don't know what to say, it's hereditary, but it seemingly it is. They have that one pace that they control the tempo, and if Arn Anderson does that, big left hand, somewhat marginal there because he was on the ropes. Another left hand, and he's got a soup bone on that end of that left arm.
Now, see, I have to believe now that Anderson's a little either worried or else he's embarrassed.
How about it, Ranger?
Interesting analogy. One thing's for sure, he has the advantage right now. If you just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, Jim Ross and Gordon Solie in Huntsville, Alabama. This is World Championship Wrestling on TBS. We'll be following tonight our 90-minute program by NBA basketball here on TBS.
Come on, Rangers.
I'll tell you something. My thoughts are fleeting toward this Friday night's Power Hour because there will not be a cage. Sawyer, Muta, and the Dragon Master anxious to sign against Anderson, Arn Anderson, Ric Flair, and Sting for this Friday night's Power Hour.
I know.
Now, I got to think there's something brewing there. They were too anxious, Gordon.
I do, too. I can't help but feel that they've got something up their sleeves. And plus the fact, I think that they would like to eliminate Flair in any of his potential title matches.
Nice slam there. Well, I'll tell you one thing about that is that Jim Cornette today in the Louisville Slugger will be talking to Buzz Sawyer, Muta, and the Dragon Master, and we'll hear their comments about Ric Flair and the Horseman, including the newest Horseman, the Stinger.
No. Nice gym ref.
Come on, Neil. Boy, look at the wide base he has. His leverage is well, well placed on the shoulder and his weight well distributed on his own feet.
And he's back far enough with that wide stance to where he's not going to be back tripped. And that, of course, what Ross would like to do. Ross turning into his man.
But Arn Anderson maintains the pressure with the wrist lock. Jerks it down there, and now Arn Anderson controlling Ranger Ross. Good reversal by the Ranger. He's set too early, and you can't make a mistake like that against Arn Anderson.
Well, and this may be the one point that we were talking about earlier. And now Anderson has that look of confidence back in his face again.
You know, Woman has really been recruiting the Horsemen, of which Arn Anderson is a prominent member. She has left Doom. She is actively, I don't know a better word to say, that she is actively recruiting the Horsemen, and specifically Ric Flair.
Ranger Ross has the arm.
I'm going to be talking to the Horsemen a little bit later in the broadcast, and I'm going to ask them about that situation because apparently she's making very strong overtures, especially, as I said, toward the Nature Boy.
Well, of course, the Nature Boy, there's a problem there. If she's interested in him, aside from business, that would... Oh, wait a minute. Ross firing back very effectively. Anderson back down again.
Rule book being amended here by Ranger Ross and Arn Anderson. And now Anderson is in another degree of trouble as Ranger Ross, who has great cardiovascular conditioning, was showing some offense, but now it's Anderson again turning the table.
Well, driving that fist into the midsection, depriving that body of oxygen. Ah, good move by
There's a kick! Ross. The combat kick, I don't think he got all of it. He's near the ropes, and Anderson's got his foot on the rope. Unfortunately for Ranger Ross, I don't think he really connected fully with the kick, but in any event, Anderson was close to the ropes.
It was sort of a glancing blow.
Whoa, 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 get off the ropes. And come on, back it
up. Now Ross is doing exactly what I suggested he should do, and that's forget about those rules sometimes, but his inexperience took him to the canvas on this one.
He became somewhat vulnerable on that second rope as Anderson turned into his advantage. He's got him up. There's that spine buster. He floats over. The spine buster, not the DDT, and Anderson is a winner. Talking about Woman, let's hear her comments and then we'll be right back.